There are a lot of questions surrounding the coronavirus pandemic. What should I do if I get sick? Am I safe in public? How prepared is the U.S. health system? Joining us now to talk about some of these issues is Dr. Gavin Macgregor-Skinner. He is an infectious disease expert, an epidemiologist, and the director of training for the Global Biorisk Advisory Council. Let's talk first about what we do to stop the system from becoming overwhelmed. What needs to happen?
Our priority right now, Brianna, is protect the national health care system, the hospitals, the clinics, the doctors, the nurses, the frontline health workers. And we need to ensure that every person in the US understands social distancing. This is why we do it, to protect our health care system. But more importantly, let's tell them how to do it. It's not isolate yourself in home, in your house and not go anywhere. It's about don't make those non-essential trips. And when you make the essential trips, whether it be by public transport, whether it be by your own car, whether you go into areas where there's other people, this is how you do proper social distancing. And I'm telling people right now, ensure that you have clothes that you wear outside and clothes that you wear inside, because when you go outside, you don't know what you've been exposed to.
It's interesting you say that. I remember once, as we were dealing with germs for our kids, when they come home from daycare, we were advised by a doctor, change clothes. The clothes from outside from the daycare go into the wash so that you have clean clothes, no germs, or less germs at least. Okay, so if you are thinking you have symptoms, you're worried you have coronavirus, you want to do something, you want to call someone, do you go to the hospital? Is there some place to call before you go to the hospital? What do you think needs to happen?
If we think about this, Brianna, if someone thinks they have symptoms, and they do actually have coronavirus, but it hasn't been diagnosed because we don't have the lab tests right now, and they go into a hospital and they spread that virus, that infection, to our frontline workers, what is the impact on that hospital that's already very, very busy, has very limited bed space? So right now we need to set up a system like here in the US, our poison help center line, the poison phone number.
Poison control number, yes.
Exactly, the 1-800 number.
You've got the magnet on your fridge. Okay, but that doesn't exist, so how does that get set up?
Then we set it up today.
Who? Who sets it up? The federal government? HHS? Who needs to do this?
Great question. Let's ensure that if the president does declare a national emergency, there is money and resources set aside, like we've seen in other countries. The UK has a NHS 111 number for those that are worried and sick, or those that have underlying medical conditions, or those that just want questions asked, they ring that number. Let's set up that 1-800 number now. Let's get it staffed. Let's ensure that everyone on the staff know the appropriate answers. And let's ensure that everyone knows, not just in English. Everything that's being produced at the moment is in English. Let's ensure that within the US, down in our communities and neighbourhoods, people speak many languages.
That's right.
We've assumed everyone understands English. Let's get the services provided. So when you ring that 1-800 number, we'll say, stay there, you're going to be okay, this is what you do, or we're going to come and pick you up and take you to a hospital, or maybe it's an alternate treatment site.
Okay, so on social distancing, I mean, I just want to be clear about, you walked into the studio, I sort of waved at you, we did not shake hands, you were sitting next to me, and I said, should we be sitting farther apart? And you said, yeah, basically, probably, yes. So we distanced you further so that we are at a more appropriate distance. There are some places where that might be tough. You want to stock up on some goods so that you don't go to the supermarket all the time. How do you deal with that? How do you deal with going to the supermarket? What needs to happen there?
Yeah, this is not just about just give people information or let them decide what to do. This is about how to train the public. How to train the public that this is what the distance should be. This is when you put any type of gloves on, when you're going to touch a lot of things. This is when you should take those gloves off and put them in the laundry or wash your hands when you've touched a lot of things. This is also going down to the neighbourhood level. How do we identify, with where I live here in Washington, D.C., people that have maybe cancer, they may have diabetes, they may have other underlying medical conditions, they may be in a certain age range that we think are high risk. How do we, as neighbours, good neighbours, go and help protect them? I'm going to do your shopping for you this week.
That's right.
You give me the list, I'll do your shopping for you. Oh, you need another errand? You need me to go to CVS or Walgreens to pick up medications? I'll do that for you. And protect the vulnerable populations.
We need an outbreak of kindness, as I've heard one doctor on our show say. It's so important. Dr. Macgregor-Skinner, thank you. We appreciate you being here.
You're welcome.